gives back. An illusion and variety show unlike you have ever seen. Featuring jaw-dropping magic, dangerous stunts, and mind-blowing illusions. Join us for an unbelievable
look at that, right? Well, you do not have to go far. You don't have to go to Vegas. No, you do not. To see a mind-blowing show just like the entertainment normally found in places like Vegas.
Nationally known magician, friend of the show, Rick Smith Jr., his team of top-notch performers, they're helping local school districts raise money. It's a really great idea. Rick, is your Magic Give Back show, it's actually a fundraising opportunity, but a good time for everybody as well.
Yeah, it's a great fundraising opportunity. Instead of kids selling magazines and cookie dough, they're selling tickets to a Las Vegas-style show that we bring to their school, which is really great.
And what a neat opportunity to expose your kids to something of that caliber, because not even a quarter of those kids are exposed to something like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like the ultimate family night. So we're bringing illusions, we're bringing lighting, trussing, special guest entertainers. We have a juggler that was just on Amazingness on MTV.
Oh, yeah.
We have some members of the Cleveland Cavaliers Scream team. We have other magicians that we work with. I mean, it's such a great show. It's about 2 hours long with a 15-minute intermission. And
parents would love it, too. I
mean, it's
it's
for all ages. And we have a show coming up this weekend at St. Ambrose. See, last time we were at St. Ambrose, there was a tornado, and we had to cancel the show, so bringing back Magic Gives Back to St. Ambrose, and tickets are available right now on MagicGivesBack.com. Tickets can range anywhere from $15 to $25, depending on where people are seated.
It's a great value, though.
It's a great value. Yeah. I mean, it's such a fun
show
bucks for a ticket
at their
like
school.
That.
Most of them we're doing at their school. Sometimes we'll pick a local auditorium nearby in the district.
I was going to ask you, so some of the schools might want to do it as a fundraiser, but they don't have a large auditorium that would fit your
show. For example, at St. Ambrose this Sunday, we're doing it in their Hilkert Hall. It's their big hall. It's their gymnasium cafeteria. So we're going to bring all the kids, parents, set up all the chairs, set up staging, trussing, curtains, everything.
That's awesome.
So, yeah, it's a fun experience.
That's fantastic. Okay, so we can find out all the information on how you can get your kids' school involved.
Yep, MagicGivesBack.com. Yeah. There's a whole bunch of shows to choose from right now just coming up. We have Brunswick, Menor, Wadsworth, Wooster, Twinsburg. These tickets are already on sale, so some of them, like Menor and Wadsworth, they're almost sold out. So,
and you're helping those schools in the process by buying the ticket.
When these schools sell out, they're raising anywhere from $10,000 to $12,000.
That's fantastic.
And just for coming to a family night,
right?
If they sell out. If they don't sell out, they make a little bit less, but it's still a really great opportunity.
Like you said, now they don't have to sell wrapping paper and
I know, and a lot of people are getting tired of
magazines.
That, so this is great.
Yes.
And the cool thing about, you know, you're seeing Rick Smith Jr. because been featured on Dude Perfect. We showed you last time when you were on there. I mean, this guy's all over the place, too, so that your kids are going to know who he is from stunts like this that we saw from Dude Perfect.
Oh, the Dude Perfect guys were so awesome to work with. At the end of this month, I'm going to be working with the slow-mo guys. They're going to take it, even that slow-motion shot, they're going to take it even slower using phantom cameras. We filmed it in Los Angeles, California. I also worked with Steve-O last week, and we have a few other surprises coming up. Even the Today Show.
Really?
No way.
Congrats.
Yeah.
That's so exciting for you. How often do you dedicate now? Because you're really mastered your craft, but you still, I'm sure, have to practice and learn new things
always have
and
to
teach
learn.
Yourself new things. How long do you dedicate to doing that, Rick?
I mean, you just got to find a trick that you want to work on and then master it. Perform it to as many people as you can. Present it with different ways of doing a card trick or something like that. At the end of this month, I'm going to be at a magic convention. It's called Magi Fest. It's in Columbus, Ohio. Young magicians, older magicians of all around the world are going to be coming there, probably about 2,000 people. And I'm going to actually be presenting card-throwing stunts and a card-throwing contest there. So any young magicians that want to learn, Magi Fest.
That's
really
fun.
So show us something like you might do for a show.
All right, this is a pretty cool trick you can do for, like, camera. For example, if you were to just grab out a card, grab any card you want, memorize it.
Okay.
Show the camera at home. What I'll do to make this a little bit more different is I like to use technology in my shows, but a lot of people have been saying that you use camera tricks and things like that. So look, I'm going to shuffle face up into face down. Okay, so we have a mess.
So they're all over the place.
I'm going to go through the cards. You're going to say stop.
Okay, stop.
Put the card back for me. Now, do you remember your card?
Yes.
So if I were to take, let's say, half the cards and shuffle them together one more time, I should be able to find your card using technology.
Okay.
Because magicians have been accused of using camera tricks. Now, they're face up, face down still, yes?
Yeah, they're still all mixed up.
I'm going to have you hold the cards. And if you don't mind, I'm going to use your phone. I'm going to take a picture of you.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Absolutely.
All right. So I'm going to go like this. I want you to hold the cards for me right here.
Okay.
I want everyone to see at home that they're mixed up. Hold the cards for me right here.
Sure.
And don't move. Don't let go either.
Okay.
All right. Ready? Look at me. Look at me. One, two, and three. Hold that. Now, even though Stephanie's looking and she's seeing that, hold on. All the cards are face up on this side.
Yeah.
All the cards are face up, face down on this side. I took one picture. And then the only picture that I took on your phone, if you look closely, you'll actually see that all the cards are face down, except for the King of Diamonds.
And I saw that when you took that. That is absolutely crazy.
Get out of here.
Because
they're still all,
they're
still
mixed
up.
Mixed on both sides.
Look at that. That was the King of Diamonds. It's what we picked.
Is that crazy? That's a good picture.
I'm going to save that.
How did
That's going to be on his Instagram later, so make sure you follow Rick Smith Jr. and this guy.
Rick fooled me.
I'm going to figure this out. I may be here the rest of my life, but
you're gonna need
I'm
to use technology.
That is amazing.
So wait, if kids want to learn this stuff, YouTube. I have a YouTube channel. I've been doing tutorials and all these videos, so follow me at Rick Smith Jr. on YouTube, Instagram. I'll tag these guys in a post, and you guys will be able to check it out.
Rick Smith Jr., always a pleasure. Magic Gives Back, by the way, all the shows and all the info on Fox8.com. Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Great to see you.
Great
Thanks
to see
for
you.
That trick.
Take care of those baby girls.
I will.
You're so cute.
Have you ever skipped an event?